My dear students, how are you everyone? I think you are well and I am also well by the grace of Almighty Allah. I am Muhammad Humayun Kabir, assistant teacher, English medium senior section, sector 7. Students, today I will conduct lecture number 54. Here, math class is very important class. So, I hope you are ready to do the class. So, let's start our today's class.
Lecture number 54. Class 6. Chapter 5. Topic: Simple Equations. Now, review. What is called equation? Equation, a mathematical sentence associated with an unknown quantity or variable. Operational sign and equality sign is the equation. Example, 2x plus 1 equal to 3 and x square minus 2 equal to 2. Here both are equation. How? Look at here, 2x plus 1 equal to 3. Here this x is unknown quantity or variable and this plus is operational sign, and here this is the equality sign we know. So we can say here this one is equation, and x square minus 2 equal to 2. Here this x square, this is the unknown quantity or variable, and here minus is operational sign and this is the equality sign. Okay, so we can say here this one is also equation. Next, what is called simple equation? Already we have learned what is called equation. Now we will learn what is called simple equation. Simple equation. Equations having variables of degree 1 is called a simple equation. That means the equation whose variables power is 1, power or degree same. Power is 1, then that equation will be a simple equation. Look at here, 2x plus 1, here this x is unknown quantity or variable, and here look at here, what is the power of x? There is no power, that means power 1. That means here this equation is simple equation, but look at here, x is square, that means x, the power of x is 2. So here this is not simple equation. Now example, here x plus 1 equal to 5, here x power is 1, so that's why here this one will be simple equation. And here 2x minus 1 equal to 3, here x power is 1, so that means variable's power is 1. Variable's power is 1, that's why this one will be what? This one will be simple equation. And here, and 2y plus 3 equal to y minus 5, so here variable is y and y's power is 1. The power of y is 1, that's why we can say this one is also a simple equation. Now next, here 2x plus 5 equal to 15 given our equation. Now we will solve this equation and we will find out the value of x. Why? Because here x is variable. Solution. After that we will write the equation, 2x plus 5 equal to 15. Now look at here in the left side. In the left side there are plus 5. In the left side there are plus 5. That's why we will subtract 5 from both sides. Now write or after that this 2x is here and this plus 5 is here. Now we will subtract 5. This 5 is here and this equal sign is here and 15 here. The right side here we will subtract 5 from both sides. So that's why we will write here minus 5. After that here you will write side note subtracting 5 from both sides. Or 2x equal to 10. How? This 2x is here. Here, if we subtract 5 from 5, then here will be what? 0. No need to write. And in the right side here, if we subtract 5 from 15, then here will be 10. Now, look at here. We want to find out the value of x. We want to find out the value of x. But this 2 is attached with x. So what will you do? We will divide by 2. But we cannot divide only one side here. We cannot divide only left side. We have to divide left side and right side also. So that's why we will divide by 2 both sides. So right here or here, this 2x is here and here. We will divide by 2. This that 2 is there. Okay, now this equal is here and 10 divided by 2. After that you will write side note dividing both sides by 2. Okay, now here if we divide 2x by 2, then here will be 1x. There will be 1x. That means coefficient is 1. Here, x's numerical coefficient is 1. When coefficient is 1, no need to write. That's why we will write only x. Okay, so here x and this equal is here. And if we divide 10 by 2, then here will be 5. So this 5 is here. So already we have got the value of x. That means our solution is x equal to 5. Our solution is x equal to 5. So solution x equal to 5. Now next, find the value of x of the following equation. Here given our equation 7 minus x equal to 9. Now we will solve this equation and we will find out the value of x. Solution. After that we will write the equation 7 minus x equal to 9. Now look at here plus 7. Here plus 7 at the beginning there is no sign, that means plus sign. So here plus 7, that's why here we will subtract 7 from both sides. So next line here write here 7 and this minus x is here and we want to subtract 7. This 7 is here and this equal is here and 9 minus 7. Write the side note subtracting 7 from both sides. Next here there are plus 7 and minus 7. If we subtract then it will be 0. No need to write. So here in the left side will be minus x, only minus x, and this equal sign is here. And if we subtract 7 from 9, if we subtract 7 from 9, then here will be 2. Now here look at here, we want to find out the value of x, but here x will be positive, but look at here x is negative, so we have to make it positive. How we'll make it positive? Here we know If we multiply minus of minus, then it will be plus. But we cannot multiply only left side. We have to multiply right side and left side also. Okay. So here we will multiply by 1. We will multiply by minus 1 both sides. Okay. So here this minus x is here multiply minus 1. Okay. And this equal sign is here and this 2 is here multiply minus 1. After that, write the side note multiplying both sides by minus 1. Okay. Now here, if we multiply this minus sign and this minus sign, then it will be plus. So that means plus x. Okay. So here plus x, and here if we multiply this plus and minus, then it will be minus. Okay. Because we know if we multiply minus and minus, then it will be plus, and if we multiply minus and plus, then it will be minus, and if we multiply plus and minus, then it will be minus, and if we multiply plus and plus, then it will be plus. So here, look at here, there is plus and minus. So if we multiply plus and minus, then it will be minus. So x equal to minus 2. Already we have got the value of x, minus 2. Now, so the value of x is minus 2. Okay. Now, students, next, at the end of the lecture, you will be able to make an equation by using alphabetical symbol, find out the value of unknown quantity by solving equation, make consecutive natural numbers equation by using alphabetical symbol. Now, today's lesson. Chapter 5, page number 118. Example 11. If 5 is subtracted from the 4 times of a number, the obtained subtraction will be 19, more than twice the number. So here, first question, if the number is x, make an equation in the light of the information. If the number is x, then we have to make equation. Number B, determine the number. Number C, if the number is the sum of 3 consecutive natural numbers, determine the smallest number. Now we will solve A, B, and C. Here, 11, example 11, if 5 is subtracted from the 4 times of a number, the obtained subtraction will be 19, more than twice the number. So first question, if the number is x, make an equation in the light of the information. Now, solution. Suppose the number is x. If 5 is subtracted from the 4 times of the number, here this is very important, the 4 times of the number. So 4 times of the number will be what? 4 times of the number will be 4x. Here number is x. So what is the 4 times of x? Here 4 times of x will be 4x. And if we subtract 5 from 4x, then it will be what? It will be 4x minus 5. So here, if 5 is subtracted from the 4 times of the number, the subtraction will be 4x minus 5. That's why here will be 4x minus 5. Next, here, if 19 is added, the twice of the number. So 19 is added twice of the number. Twice of the number will be what? Here number is x. So what is the twice of x? Twice of x will be twice x. And If we add 19 with 2x, then it will be what? 2x, 2x plus 19. So the sum will be 2x plus 19. And according to the question here, look at here, according to the question here, this 4x minus 5 and 2x plus 19, it will be equal. So according to the question, 4x minus 5 equal to 2x plus 19. Next, determine the number. Determine the number. Solution: from A, we have got here, from A, we have got our equation, what? 4x minus 5 equal to 2x plus 19. From A, we have got this equation, 4x minus 5 equal to 2x plus 19. Okay, now we will solve this equation and we will find out the value of x. Why? Because this x is our number. And here we have to determine the number, that's why. So here we will start with or, and look at here, in the left side there are minus 5. In the left side, minus 5. That's why here we need to add plus 5. But if we want to add plus 5, then we have to add both sides. Okay. So that's why here we will add plus 5 on both sides. So right here, 4x minus 5, and we want to add 5. This 5 is here. And this equal is here, and this 2x is here, and plus 19. Okay, now we want to add 5. This 5 is here. After that, right side note, adding 5 to both the side. Adding 5 to both the side. Now here, look at here, this 4x is here, and here plus 5 and minus 5. So if we subtract 5 from 5, then it will be 0. Okay, now in the right side, this 2x is here, and if we add 5 with 19, then it will be 24. So this 24 is here. Now next, look at here, in the right side there are 2x. The right side there are 2x. This 2x here, there are plus 2x. Okay, so that's why we will subtract 2x from both sides. So 4x, this 4x is here, and we want to subtract 2x. This 2x is here, minus 2x, and this equal is here, and in the right side this 2x is here, plus 24. Now minus 2x. Okay, after that here, right side note, subtracting 2x from both the side. Here in the left side, there are plus 4x minus 2x. So if we subtract 2x from 4x, then it will be 2x. And this equal is here. And in the right side here, if we subtract 2x from 2x, then it will be 0. No need to write. So here will be only plus 24. Plus 24. Okay. Now we want to find out the value of x. Okay. But these two attached to x, so what will we do? Here we will divide by 2. So this 2x is here, and we want to divide by 2. That 2 is here, and this equal is here. Next, 24 divided by 2. Dividing both sides by 2. You have to write the side note. Now, next here, if we divide 2 by 2, then here we 1. That means 1x. And we know coefficient is 1, no need to write. That's why here we will write only x. And 24 divided by 2, if we divide 24 by 2, then it will be 12. Okay. That means already we have got the value of x. That means already we have got the number. Okay, so what is our number? Our number is 12. So the number is 12. Now, before solving question number C, here we will learn consecutive number, because this concept we will use on this question number C. That's why here we will learn, at first we will learn consecutive number. Okay, so consecutive number, what is consecutive number? The number that follows each other continuously, that follows each other continuously in the order from smallest to largest are called consecutive numbers. Okay, so here example 4 5 6 4 5 6. Now look at here, if we start with 4, then here 5 comes continuously 5 6, and here smallest to largest, that's why here 4 5 6 are consecutive number. Like this way you can say 5 6 7, it will be consecutive number, or 7 8 9 will be consecutive number. Like this way you can say unlimited consecutive number. Okay, now they have a difference of 1 between every two numbers. Suppose here if we consider 4 and 5, so what is the difference between 4 and 5? 1. And here 5 and 6, what is the difference between 5 and 6? 1. So every two numbers difference is 1. Okay, now students, question number C, if the number is the sum of 3 consecutive natural numbers, determine the smallest number. So here solution, from B we have got the number is 12. Now, suppose the first consecutive natural number be y. Let first consecutive natural number will be y. So next consecutive natural number, how we will get? Here, so second consecutive natural number will be y plus 1. And the third consecutive natural number will be y plus 2. Now here, according to the question, look at here, according to the question, the number is the sum of 3 consecutive natural numbers. That means here, if we add these 3 consecutive natural numbers, then their summation will be 12. Okay, so according to the question, what we can write here, according to the question, we have to write these 3 consecutive natural numbers summation. Okay, so here y plus 1, second consecutive number, and third consecutive number y plus 2, we will add 3 consecutive natural number, and their summation will be here 12. Okay, summation will be the number, and we have got the number is 12, that's why summation will be 12. Now we will solve this equation and we will find out the value of y. Okay, then we will get smallest consecutive natural number. So here this y is here, and here y plus 1, right here y plus 1, and plus y plus 2 here, y plus 2, and this equal is here, and this 3 is here. Now look at here y plus y plus y. So if we add, then here will be plus 3y, and here 1 plus 2, so if we add, then it will be plus 3. So here 3y plus 3 equal to 12. Okay, now here in the left side there are plus 3, in the left side here plus 3. Okay, So what will we do? We will subtract 3 from both sides. Here 3y plus 3 minus 3. We want to subtract 3, that 3 is here, equal to 12 minus 3. 12 minus 3, we want to subtract 3, this that 3 is here. After that, write the side note, subtracting 3 from both the sides. Now here this 3y is here, and here plus 3 minus 3, if we subtract, then here will be 0, no need to write. And this equal is here, and 12 minus 3, that means here if we subtract 3 from 12, then it will be 9. Now look at here we want to find out the value of y. We want to find out the value of y, but here this 3 is attached with y. So what will we do? Here we will divide by 3 both sides. Okay, so this 3y is here, and we want to divide by 3, that 3 is here, and equal here 9 divided by 3. Write the side note, dividing both sides by 3. Now here look at here, if we divide this 3 by 3, then here will be 1, that means 1y. Numerical coefficient is 1. We know coefficient is 1, no need to write. And here if we divide 9 by 3, then it will be 3. Okay, so already we have got the value of y, that means already we have got the smallest consecutive natural number. So what the smallest number will be 3. The smallest number will be 3. Okay, students, I hope it is very clear to you. Now, summary. We have learned how to make an equation by using alphabetical symbol. We have learned how to find out the value of unknown quantity by solving equation. We have learned how to make consecutive natural numbers equation by using alphabetical symbol. Here in our question number C, we have learned how to make consecutive natural numbers equation and how to solve this one. Okay, now online homework number 54, chapter 5, page number 117. So question number 10, example 10. Shiha bought 6 pens from a shop and gave a note of 50 taka to the shopkeeper. The shopkeeper returned 20 taka. Shiha bought 3 exercise books, each costing y taka, from another shop. Then, your first question, from an equation by shopping, each pen costing x taka. That means here you have to make an equation, each pen's cost is x taka. Number B, find the cost of each pen. That means here you will, in our question number A, here you will make equation, and in the second B number, here you will solve the equation and you will find out the cost of each pen, that means every pen. C number, if the cost of 3 exercise books be equal to the cost of 6 pens, what does each exercise book cost? Here this SW, students, this SW you will do on time and you will submit in time.
Students, I hope you understood the class. Here I have solved some equation and I am trying to make you understand. So if you do not understand any part, then that part you will see again and again. And if you have any major problem, then when teacher will take the Zoom class, you will tell to teacher and he will make you understand. Thank you everyone to see the class. See you next class.